Hello, Virgo. Welcome to Royal Mystic. Welcome back to all my subscribers and previous viewers, and welcome to all new viewers to my channel. This is a general reading for all Virgos, a collective reading for July 1st through 15th to allow some insight into some of the energies that are going on with Virgos at this time and give some just a look at what's happening, so you'll have the ability to remain on your highest path. So what I do is I ask for divine light, divine universal guidance, angels, saints, archangels, divine spirit, spirit guides, and higher selves, universal divine white light. These cards are jumping out for you. Got lots of energy for you, Virgo. To allow me to give Virgo, that one didn't flip, Virgo the insight they need to remain on your highest possible path. These really great cards coming out here for you, Virgo. Okay, we're just going to keep it going. This is your relationship, close interpersonal relationship and love life and or. And this is your finance and career. Your underlying energy is the Four of Cups. Four of Cups is basically the divine offering something or some divine connection coming through for you. Maybe it may be through some kind of omen, like seeing an animal or some kind of peculiar is popping into my mind. Some peculiar circumstance. So when you see this particular thing, or when you feel like this is something that's being brought in by the divine to catch your attention, pay attention to what you were thinking about, because that'll give you a telltale to what it's about. This is a divine gift. Four is a beautiful foundation. It's a good, strong foundation. And to complete it, this is being offered to you from the divine. So you're being hesitant, and we're going to see why here in a minute. It may be that you're being a Virgo. Virgos are a little standoffish at first, unless they know you. So you've got the Four of Swords. Four of Swords never fails. Every time this card comes out, it's about somebody who is burning the candle at both ends, maybe under the weather and still trying to keep moving the way they were moving before whatever this was that happened, an illness or some kind of injury, not a major injury, just something small, sprained ankle, something like that, and just still trying to walk on it before it's time. Trying to get up and do every single thing that you were doing before, and not letting yourself have the time to recuperate. So this is a rest, recover, recuperate card. Please take care of yourself. You can't do anything if you're down and out. So allow yourself time to recover and time to rest. Okay, so this is a gift from the universe. This is cheers to you. It's an absolute satisfaction and literally toasting the room. So maybe you're celebrating a little too much and you got to have a time to recover from that. That doesn't seem like it what it is for me. It feels like that this is a long, hard work, and finally you've reached that place that you feel like, oh my God, finally we're past this particular thing, whatever it is. And then you're saying, this is the thank God it's over. Thank God, thank God, thank God. We've gotten past whatever the point was of that you completed, whatever this task was that's got you worn out. And the Star card. So these are both your wish being granted. One of them is like more of a physical, situational wish, more about your physical comfort and satisfaction of life in general. And this is a soul wish. So this is your higher self. Your third eye is lit up. Your soul is here present. This is your soul just lighting the world up, lighting this plane of existence up. And this can also be the sign of an Aquarius because it's a water bearer. But this is, and so there may be Aquarius involved, but you are lighting up like a Christmas tree here. This is you leveling up spiritually. Some kind of breakthrough is happening. So you are definitely having a spiritual revelation here. This is a soul wish. Sometimes we don't realize what our soul is asking for from the divine. And we have to understand that the soul knows what's better for you than you do. So we have to let that happen. It's coming for you. That's your here and now energy. You got the Death card. This is change. This is removing obstacles. This is basically cutting you free of anything that no longer serves you. Losing the dead weight is what I've just heard. This is the Hierophant. This is can be spiritual as far as a spiritual organization. It can be a large conglomerate or some kind of corporation. It's an entity of It's an entity of government or some kind of council. I'm hearing council. So this for someone has to do with a council. You got the Two of Wands here, which is a choice to take. One, you know, it's a fork in the road. So just so you know, whether you take the short, what seems like the short path, it'll have its own pitfalls. It may take longer to get there because you think it's going to be the smooth path, but it just is a little longer. And what this one makes up for in length, this one is the shorter path over the mountain, but it's a more treacherous path. So in your life, that this happens many times, we have to make choices. And just know that they're running parallel. The two roads are running parallel. But that doesn't mean that one choice is better than the other. It just depends on what lesson your soul needs to learn at the time. And usually we're attracted to the choice that we need. So allow yourself to use your intuition on making the choice. Okay, so here in your career, in your finances, you've got the Sun card. This card is telling you that you are in alignment. The planets are coming into alignment. It's like a lock in a cylinder. The little gears have to get all in a row before the key actually works. So this is lining up for you to be able to open the door to your new future. So this is a card of happiness and joy and prosperity. You've got the Magician right under that. The Magician is using his power of his heart energy to bring in to his life the things that he needs. He's using the universal energy coming in, turning it into his heart chakra, and using the vibration of love to bring in what he needs. That's the highest vibration. It's the most pure and it's the most powerful. So you got to keep your mind right to do that. Now you've got the Tower. The Tower is a sudden change. This can be something that was based on false information or untruth. Anything that is built on an unsecure foundation that maybe you didn't know all the facts. Somebody tried to pull the wool over your eyes, or somebody has been kind of doing something underhanded, and they're going to be either found out. If it was not disclosed to you, you're going to find out, which will bring all their house of cards down. It's going to tear down whatever they had built up for you, making you feel like they had the upper hand. There, it's all coming, falling down for them. So we're going to do some clarifiers for you, Virgo. Thank you, angels, archangels, spirit guides, divine spirit, and beautiful white light for being here and present to help me clarify this reading for Virgo for the first half of July 2018. Thank you. And the King of Swords is your underlying energy here. This is the Archangel Michael. This is the sword of truth and justice, and it will knock down any obstacles and cut you free from any things that are trying to hang on to you that no longer belong in your life. Okay, so the Seven of Rods is you standing your ground or fending something off. These are people that could be jealous or could be gossiping about you, and you're not hearing it, you're not participating in it, and you're telling them to back off. You're not going to let them pass. So you're tired, but you may be tired from dealing with this kind of stuff. So you've got this Nine of Cups with the fabulous Wheel of Fortune on top. So what this Nine of Cups represents is the universe saying, yes, your wish is granted. If you're looking for something, an answer to something, the answer is yes. This is the universe saying yes with this Nine of Cups. The Wheel of Fortune is saying it's turning in your favor. So it's a second confirmation that it is turning in your favor. Okay, so here's the Hierophant again. This is the same card that was over here. Okay, so the Hierophant is like a blessing. Okay, so if you're seeking someone's counsel, you're asking them maybe permission for something, or you're wanting their blessing. That's what this is here. And it's literally giving you the keys to the city. Okay, or to whatever, the key to whatever it is. I used the lock metaphor earlier, so maybe that's more profound for some of you. Okay, and the universe combining with your higher self actually making the connection to universal energy. And this is the All Believers card. I can't think of a more beautiful card to be on top of that. This is whatever your heart believes, stay focused, stay vigilant. Don't let other people try to convince you otherwise. That's what this card is. Because you are on the right path. This is your soul's path. So for someone out there, this is the confirmation they needed for that. Okay? These two cards are amazing together, the Death card and the Ace of Swords. All aces are a new beginning, and this particular ace is the Ace of Truth and Justice and will cut away anything that binds you. And this is the release and change of that. So, this is a new beginning on top of the ending of whatever this is. This is being removed. Herein comes the new beginning, brand new from the universe. It's a gift. You've got the laurel wreath, which is victory, and the light of the heavens coming down. That means the storm is passing. It's a breakthrough. The stronghold is being lifted. Okay, so the Hierophant, the blessing, the counsel, new beginning, Ace of Wands. Now, this may be a marriage for someone, or a new relationship coming in, or reigniting a new marriage, or a marriage, a previous marriage, because this is a fertile, beautifully planted wand, and the sun rays are beaming up like the new beginning. I told you all aces are new beginnings. You got two aces in a row, okay? So someone may be tying the knot. There's the choices, two roads, and the hero's welcome. So whatever the choice is, whatever task you have to go down the road to do, you come back a hero. This again, laurel wreath, beautiful wands. You've got the combination of these two cards here in that one card. So you've got this is literally a ticker tape parade being thrown in your honor. Huge recognition, whatever it is you've overcome, you're proud of yourself and others are proud of you as well. Okay, so you've got the sun in your career and finance, which is joy, peace, happiness, wonderful opportunities, all systems go. And the Six of Swords, which is you coming out of the storm, coming into calmer waters, bringing all of the energy and information and experience from your past into this new beginning. You're launching in the right direction. Okay, so you've got the Seven of Swords on top of the Magician. Now, some people believe that the Magician is a trickster. I do not. And some people believe that the Seven of Swords is a thief. I do not. What I think this is letting go of old ways and leaving them behind here. Letting yourself understand that you can only carry what you need, and the rest, the extra, has to be left behind for you to be able to manifest what you want for the future. You've got to have some space for it to happen. So you may have some trepidation about this, and you're kind of thinking, you know, well, I really hate to leave that behind, but I have to so I can move forward. I can't carry all of it with me. I can't take everything with me. I just heard you can't take it with you when you go. So somebody's getting that one. The Tower, the big change, and the opportunity being offered from the heavens. Same card as this one right here, your underlying energy. So it all wraps up to the same bit of information. No matter what this change brings, it will open an opportunity for you, a blessing from heaven. Just be paying attention to that. Don't ignore it. So that's it for you, Virgo. I hope you have a wonderful first half of July. Many blessings. Namaste. You guys rock, 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 because I got 26,000 views from you, almost 27,000, just on the last second half of June. So many blessings. Keep them coming. All the wonderful comments. I enjoy it. And I enjoy helping you. So thank you so much for everyone who's hired me and all of you for liking, sharing, and subscribing. Don't forget to hit that button. If you'd like a private reading, please go to royalmystic.com. Thank you so much. Namaste. Happy 4th of July.